A Kidnapped Santa Claus by L. Frank Baum. Narrated by B.J. Harrison. Santa Claus lives in the Laughing Valley, where stands the big, rambling castle in which his toys are manufactured. His workmen, selected from the Rills, Nooks, Pixies, and Fairies, live with him, and everyone is as busy as can be from one year's end to the other. It is called the Laughing Valley because everything there is happy and gay. The brook chuckles to itself as it leaps rollicking between its green banks. The wind whistles merrily in the trees. The sunbeams dance lightly over the soft grass, and the violets and wildflowers look smilingly up from their green nests. To laugh, one needs to be happy. To be happy, one needs to be content. And throughout the Laughing Valley of Santa Claus, contentment reigns supreme. On one side is the mighty forest of Bursey. At the other side stands the huge mountain that contains the caves of the demons. And between them, the valley lies smiling and peaceful. One would think that our good old Santa Claus, who devotes his days to making children happy, would have no enemies on all the earth. And as a matter of fact, for a long period of time, he encountered nothing but love wherever he might go. But the demons who lived in the mountain caves grew to hate Santa Claus very much. And all for the simple reason that he made children happy. The caves of the demons are five in number. A broad pathway leads up to the first cave, which is a finely arched cavern at the foot of the mountain, the entrance being beautifully carved and decorated. In it resides the demon of selfishness. Back on this is another cavern inhabited by the demon of envy. The cave of the demon of hatred is next in order, and through this one passes to the home of the demon of malice. Situated in a dark and fearful cave in the very heart of the mountain. I do not know what lies beyond this. Some say there are terrible pitfalls leading to death and destruction, and this may very well be true. However, from each one of the four caves mentioned, there is a small, narrow tunnel leading to the fifth cave, a cozy little room occupied by the demon of repentance. And as the rocky floors of these passages are well worn by the track of passing feet, I judge that many wanderers in the caves of the demons have escaped through the tunnels to the abode of the demon of repentance, who is said to be a pleasant sort of fellow who gladly opens for one a little door admitting you into fresh air and sunshine again. Well, these demons of the caves, thinking they had a great cause to dislike old Santa Claus, held a meeting one day to discuss the matter.
"I'm really getting lonesome," said the demon of selfishness. "For Santa Claus distributes so many pretty Christmas gifts to all the children that they become happy and generous through his example and keep away from my cave."
"I am having the same trouble," rejoined the demon of envy. "The little ones seem quite content with Santa Claus, and there are few indeed that I can coax to become envious."
"And that makes it bad for me,"
declared the demon of hatred.
"For if no children pass through the caves of selfishness and envy, none can get to my cavern."
"Or to mine," added the demon of malice.
"For my part," said the demon of repentance, "it is easily seen that if children do not visit your caves, they can have no need to visit mine, so that I am quite as neglected as you are."
"And all because of this person they call Santa Claus," exclaimed the demon of envy. "He is simply ruining our business, and something must be done at once."
To this they readily agreed, but what to do was another and more difficult matter to settle. They knew that Santa Claus worked all through the year at his castle in the Laughing Valley, preparing the gifts he was to distribute on Christmas Eve.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.